Okay, so now the reason I brought up in the last video number three the slow and the fast is because in John's book he mentions that you don't have to slow down to get rid of the pain. The pain will make you think that you have to be bedridden. The pain will make you think that you have to be in a wheelchair. The pain will make you think that you have to be sitting at your desk, resting with your feet up and all that other stuff. The pain will make you think that you need to be in traction in the hospital. The pain will be so severe sometimes it'll make you think that you have to go to the chiropractor and get your neck adjusted and your bones adjusted. But you can actually move at normal speed and do things at normal pace. You can jog, you can work out, you can do all kinds of the normal stuff that you usually do, and but all you have to do is use your self-talk to get rid of the pain. And sometimes it goes away just like that, and I've noticed this. And sometimes it takes a day or two or a week for it to go away, sometimes a month. I remember it took me a month just to get rid of some pain, a brand new pain in the middle of my back when I was out chopping some freshly cut cypress wood from a tree that was this big around. And this is how big the rounds were, and they were that thick. And it was very hard to chop, but I could do it. But on my very last chop, all of a sudden, and it stayed with me for a solid month until I was laying in my bed with my self-talk one night and watching Abraham Hicks videos and coming to that Kundalini experience of half asleep, half awake, entering into the eternal life. And all of a sudden I felt it just melt away. And it only did it because I embraced the pain this time. That time I went straight on with the pain and I went into the pain and I felt the pain for all it was. And then it disappeared. I'm not saying that all pain disappears that way. I'm just saying for me, that time I had to go into the pain and embrace it. And that's what you call, like, that's what you call shadow work. And there's this YouTuber called Teal. And she will introduce you to what shadow work is. All that shadow work is just going into your childhood history and finding the root to the cause of your pain. And that would be described as meeting it head on or embracing the pain. And sometimes it'll take you a while in your memories to go into your memories to find out the root, childhood root. As to when it all started, what was the first event, the first day that it started in your childhood memory that created this pattern of pain in your life, in our life, in my life. So, and it does take the help of cannabis to slow your system down so you can think slowly and deeply without distraction. That's an option though, but it is highly recommended. Okay, so like I was saying, when we feel the pain and we know what the source of the pain is, we see the animal brain's fight for superiority, and that is that it at its root, the animal brain does not want us to dissect our emotions and to figure out our emotional responses. What it would rather have us do is distract us from our emotional responses so that we can't figure out what's going on. And the way it distracts our mind from sitting down and being real with ourselves, the way that it does it is it sends pain to the body. And if you got pain, well, then you can't think straight because all you're thinking on is your pain. And now when you're thinking on your pain, see, that's a good thing, because that pain is actually bringing you out of the rushing rivers of painful thoughts and making you focus and ground yourself on your body. That's for those who go in and actually heal themselves. But for those who are just dragged along in life by the pain, not knowing what the cause of it is and not knowing how to heal it, they are constantly affected by the pain as they continue through life, and they operate in life, go to work and work jobs in severe pain all day. And I know what that's like. And there are descriptions of people on the John E. Sarno YouTube videos, especially one doctor who just lived through the pain day, all day. He put pillows on his chairs and stuff like that, and he'd just be in constant burning pain. Well, I never put pillows on my chairs or anything like that. I was more of one to just, I just suffered with it. I didn't try to do anything about it. I just suffered with the burning pain all day. And some days were worse than others, and I noticed it was because I overexerted myself. Like, I'll play my guitar too fast, too hard, and singing too hard, too fast. But then, by the end of the night, I wake up in the morning, and boom, the next morning, it's gone. It just happened like me for that, sometimes like that. Other days, it would be with me for a full week. Now, the root of all this pain is called imbalance. So, in John's book, he does give some self-talk. So, see if I can find some self-talk in here. And when I say the self-talk in this book is called legal self-talk. And it primarily deals with those of us that are under the assumptive jurisdiction of Mother Nature's legal system that she put in place. There are some, here we go. Daily reminders. As you can see, I study books, so there's pens all over this book, all over the pages. I read this book about 15 years ago, so more like 12 years ago. So here are some legal self-talks you can do. And remember, legal self-talk is different from lawful self-talk, because lawful self-talk has to do with our commercial lien and our security agreement in private maritime law. And all we have to do is apply the faith, name it and claim it, faith movement, Benny Hinn, Trinity Broadcasting Network, faith movement confirmations to ourselves. Which, by the way, most Benny Hinn and Trinity Broadcasting Networks, all their faith movements are legal self-talks. Now, when I say mix lawful self-talk with the Trinity Broadcasting Faith Movement Network, what I'm doing is I'm saying that lawful self-talk is all rooted in the law of attraction. And although Trinity Broadcasting Network, for the most part, is legal self-talk, they have brought the law of attraction by way of the infiltration of the fundamental church and brought this wonderful information called the law of attraction to the people. But keep in mind, it's legal. It's the legal side. It's the legal side until such time as the church grows up into the lawful side. And they are going to start doing that, because everyone on earth is going to learn private maritime law. And they're going to learn how to enter into the law of agreement. Now, the law of agreement is self-talk. Like I said, this is legal self-talk. The law of agreement self-talk has to do with repeating your security agreement to yourself. And in the words of your security agreement are some verbiage that goes like this. Anyone that wants to try to collect from my corporation, which is the same as the all capitalized name, which is the straw man, anyone who wants to try to collect must pay me first, the real man, $750 billion, or an unlimited amount as I see fit. And if you notice in the faith movement, they always tell you that all you have to do is speak it into existence, and you say to yourself, prosperity is coming to me. Sickness, illness, disease, poverty, you have no hold over me. So all you got to do lawfully is just remind yourself that nothing can collect from me, and no one can collect from me. Nothing means all disease, poverty, unhealth, sickness, illness, fear, rage, anxiety, sadness, depression, none of that stuff can collect from me. So all you're doing is you're just doing lawful self-talk, and you're reminding yourself, oh, I got a security agreement and a commercial lien. Nothing, no poverty can collect from me. So when you have the pain coming to your body, like my severe tailbone pain, I just tell myself, no pain can collect from my well-being, my health. No pain can collect from me. I have a security agreement and a commercial lien. No corporate pain has the right to collect from this body because I have a lien on this body. I have a claim of lien. I have a claim of lien on the title, the legal title to this body, which is the prison system's title that was created by Mother Nature. So remember, so the legal self-talk is for those of us who don't understand private maritime law, and we're still under the assumption of the public attorneys, which are supposed to be there, that Mother Nature sent there as ministers to help us to grow, to come out from needing a nanny. So, some of the examples of self-talk in here are this. You just tell yourself this. And you can also speak these legal self-talks for yourself, even though you're under law. You can go both ways. But the legal people can't go both ways, because they have not put in their security agreement and their commercial lien yet. Although they can speak it forth in faith that they will have their commercial liens and their security agreements, which is just another word for international peace treaties, which is just another word for you are your own nation now, and you can create your own money. And that money has to be accepted by the public, retailers, and they have to take it to the Treasury currency exchange departments, known as the U.S. Treasury, which is just another word for International Monetary Fund. It's all the same. All corporations are the same. It's just the planetary money exchange, currency exchange building. That's all it is. There are 7 billion people on this earth. That means everybody is a potential prince of peace, which means they are a potential nation unto themselves, which means they can potentially create their own money. And since how we're still using the paper money system while we're in this prison planet, all we got to do is send the retailers our own special paper money, and we can write on it anything we want, because all paper money is backed by our signature that is on the security agreement and the commercial liens that are posted in the public record. And So you can create your own money any way you want. You can use a crayon and a piece of paper if you want. But for the most part, it does help to, you know, I just use checks. I just use regular bank checks. And I just put grantor and the name in the upper left-hand corner. Down at the bottom, I sign it with the all capitalized name written also. And I put trustee, and I put my website to my lien on the check anywhere that I want. Or if I'm registered with the Secretary of State, I could put my lien number on the check. And on the back, we can endorse the check to ourselves because we are the grantor, we're the creator of it, we're the backing of it, of everything in that birth certificate, U.S. Treasury birth certificate application account. We're the trustee, which means we're the distributor. We decide when and where it's going to be, the money's going to come to us. And number three, we are the beneficiary, which means we are the receiver of all that credit money, which is just money of account, which is just press the easy button, so that we don't have to keep cutting down trees to make paper money all the time. And so you sign it on the back like you would a book to a page, like here's your check. Let's just do it this way. Here's your check. Up here in the upper left-hand corner is your name printed on the check. You just take your pen, you put grantor, dash grantor. Down here at the bottom of the check, you sign it, put your lien number on there, or your website, where your lien can be seen, and you put dash trustee. You sign your name, and underneath your name, you write all capitalized letters for your name. And when you turn the check around, just like a book, this would be the upper left-hand corner again, and you go down to the end of the page, which is the up lower right-hand corner, and you write sideways on it, just like you're signing your check, and you put the same thing. Put your signature, and underneath your signature, put your all-capitalized name, because you are both the living man and the straw man, and then underneath that, you just put trustee. As simple as that. Now you have you just created your own money. It's a simple way to create your own money. Simple way. And these are called dream tickets. And you can check out some of the Ken Roberts videos. I'll put a link to the video of how you create your dream tickets. Okay, so I'll just stop the video there and we'll do that.